In this Excel VBA tutorial, let's take a look at creating a function that's going to sum values based on cell background color. Until now, Excel doesn't have a standard formula that helps us do this, so we're going to create our own custom VBA function. Let's get started. The way I want it to work is to go to the formula bar, to type in my formula, so let's just call this sum color. I want this formula to have two arguments. The first argument is going to be the cell that contains the color I want. So in this case, it would be this cell. The second argument is going to be the range that I want to sum. Okay, and then when I close the bracket and I press enter, I want to see, in this case, I want to see 40. Right, so now I haven't programmed this formula yet, so we don't see it. But once we get it right, we should see 40 here. And then when I pull this down, I have to fix this reference, but when I pull this down, I want this cell to show 77 and the one for green to show 80. Okay, so let's see how we can set that up. Let's bring up the Visual Basic Editor, Alt F11, and let's create a new module for this. So right mouse click, insert module, and I'm going to call it Project Activity. Now, this is not a sub procedure. Instead, it's a function procedure. And the name of the function is basically going to be the name of the formula that we're going to be using. So let's call this sumColor. Inside the brackets are the arguments that we need. I mentioned that I want two arguments. One was for color, and the other one was the range that we're going to sum. But to keep things simple in the first round, let's just assume that the color is fixed. So let's fix it to the red color here. And let's just have one argument for this. When we get it to work for this red color, then in a second step, we can make the color variable, right? So I'm just doing that to keep things simple. It's just like when you work with complex Excel formulas, you generally start off with writing the core first and then you expand on it. So that's kind of using the same technique here. My one argument here is going to be the range, right? The range that I want to loop through and check for that cell color. So I'm going to call that sum range as range. I want the result of this function to be a number, so I'm going to do as double. Now, since I'm planning to loop through a range, I'm going to dim cell as range, and then let's do our loop. So for each cell in sum range, right? Because this is the argument that defines the range I need to loop through. It's the range that the user is going to highlight here. So for each cell that's inside this highlighted range, which is here my sum range, let's just close this loop, next cell. I want to check if the cell color equals this red color here. I need to figure out what color code this one has. And actually, let's just do that using the immediate window here. So I'm going to click on this, bring up Visual Basic again. If you don't have the immediate window activated, you can activate it by going to View, Immediate Window. It's a great tool for querying things as well. So not just testing your code, but also querying. I'm going to start with a question mark and get the cell color of this active cell here so that I can use it in my code. Let's start with active cell. Dot. Now, how do I get to the color? Is it color directly? I don't see it pop up here. There is something in between, and that's the interior property or the interior object dot color. Okay, so I see that this color code for this red cell is 255. So I'm going to use that here, and I'm going to check if my cell dot interior dot color equals 255, then let's do an end if here. Then I want the result of my sum color formula. So sum color should equal sum color, right? So the value that it has at that point plus the cell dot value, so the red cell that it comes across inside this loop. Okay, that's it. So let's just check if this part works. I'm just going to go here and start typing it in. Sum color, I see it pop up here. I'm going to highlight this range. And what should I get now? 77. right? It works. So now let's expand on this and make the color selection dynamic. Okay, so I need to add an argument to this, and I want that color selection to be the first argument. So let's call that match color as range, because they're going to click on a cell. And let's just change the C to a capital C here. I want to grab the color of the cell that the user clicks on. So let's declare a variable for that. I'll call it my color as long. So the way I'm going to grab the color is by grabbing that color code. Now, before we enter the loop, we can already grab that color code from the first cell that the user selects. My color is going to equal to match color. Now I'm going to go with dot cells 1, 1. So in theory, the user should click on one cell, but it could be that they just drag it down and select many cells. I just want to make sure that the macro is going to pick up the first cell in that range. So I do dot cells 1, 1. Now I need dot interior dot color. Okay, now all I have to do is to replace that 255 with my color. That should be it. Let's test that here. Equals some color. I'm going to click on this insert function button here. I can see the name of the arguments here. Now match color is this cell and the sum range is this range. I'm just going to fix this with the F4 key and click on OK. So I get 40 here. Now let's just drag this down. 77 and 80 here. Okay, so it looks great. Let's just check one thing. What if I change the cell color of this one to red as well? Okay, so this looks like the same red. This doesn't update. Why doesn't it update? It's because I haven't changed a value inside the cell. I'm just changing the formatting of the cell, and that's not going to pull through. It only is going to pull through if I go to my formula and I actually press enter here so that it recalculates, or if I press Ctrl+Alt+F9. This way I'm going to force a calculation. But let's say I don't want to do that. I don't want to be changing these and always remembering to force calculation by pressing Ctrl+Alt+F9. What I can do is to create an event, a selection change event that's going to run a calculation every time I change something in this area. Let's bring up Visual Basic and let's go to the code window of this sheet. So this sheet is called Activity and that's Activity here. So I'm just going to double click it to bring up the code window. So here I'm going to use the selection change event. So every time I select a cell and I move from a cell, this calculation is going to run. All I have to do is select worksheet here because selection change is the default event for this object. Now, you could just write activesheet.calculate and this is going to run a calculation anytime you move, right? Anytime you make a move or change your selection, it's going to run a calculation. And that might be a bit of an overkill for my tool, so I don't want it to do that. I just want it to run a calculation every time I change something, let's just say in these columns, right? You could even restrict it to a specific range here. So what I can do is to use the intersect method to check for this. If there is an intersection between my range here that I defined, so let's say columns A to C and the target argument here, then it should run a calculation. Otherwise, it shouldn't run it. And the thing with the intersect method is that it's going to return always different ranges depending on where the intersect is. And remember, we said that sometimes it's better to tell VBA what something isn't instead of what something is, right? So we covered that when we learned about the intersect method. So here I'm going to check if not intersect of target, so my target argument here, and the range that I'm going to define, so its range is going to be my columns A to C, is nothing, then let's do an end if here, and the activesheet.calculate goes in between. Okay, so anytime there is an intersection between wherever I click here, that's target, and this range here, the calculation is going to run. Okay, when I click here, there is no intersection, calculation is not going to run. So let's try that. I'm going to change this to the yellow, and I'm going to click away, and it's going to update. I'm going to change this to green, this one, and click away, and it's 119. Okay, so all you have to do is to click away so that selection change is going to run. If you found this video useful, please hit that thumbs up. If you want to learn Excel VBA in a structured way with lots of hands-on projects, check out the link below. Thank you for watching.